What's up guys, this is Ronnie. Welcome back to our channel Total Technology. So again, I'm gonna continue the Neo4j series, and let me just quickly write down the correct name. So this is going to be tutorial 23. So in this topic, I'm gonna talk about three very important keyword. Let me just like starts with, ends with, and another one is contents. So I'm gonna talk about this three keyword or reserved keyword, and we'll see some very basic use cases like how you can use this. So initially I will do it from Neo4j Cypher console, and after that I'll use the same thing from Python like Eclipse. So let me just open the Neo4j thing over here. So so if I run this thing, so let's say, so Vicky, city is Delhi and department IT, name is Vicky. So what I'll do, I'll try to create some sort of like use case for this. So let's like match match like n, okay, where n dot nm starts with, let's keep like V, return n dot name. So here only Vicky has a name which is actually starts with V. So if you do this thing, see, like this, okay. So next thing, what we can do, like okay, so let's change it to ends with, okay, ends with Y. So Vicky and Daisy, there are two things, so it should return two. See, Daisy and Vicky. So if we say like K Vicky, so we have seen the use case of starts with, ends with, and now we'll see contents. So TAI, okay, Vicky, or let's T, Rohit. This is very simple, it's very simple, very natural, and very normal thing. So what I'll do, I'll try to do the same thing from here. So from Neo4j import graph database, and after that driver is going to be like, sorry, okay, then this, then the, okay, my internet is not working, I'm not sure what is the problem. Let me just quickly, sorry guys, I'm just getting one call. Hello. So okay guys, so here we need to give the this bolt protocol URL, and then the authentication parameter. So Neo4j, and my password is like Rambo. Okay, similarly, now session is going to be like driver dot session, okay. Okay, now the query q1. So q1 is going to be, and we'll write this thing like, okay, match n where in dot name starts with V. Okay, then return n dot name. Then data equals to session dot run q1, and for name in data print name. So let's see what is Wiki. So if I starts with R, it's Rohit. Now if you make it small, see nothing, because this is case sensitive. So please remember this thing, this is case sensitive. Okay, and another one is D, so it should return Daisy. So we have seen everything with starts with. Now we can see like ends with, and let's keep Y, so it should return Daisy and Wiki. And if I give it to SY, then only Daisy. And if I give it KY, then Wiki. So ends with is also fine. Similarly, we can do it like contains Wiki, right? So last but not least, we can change it to some sort of like parameter V, then X, and we'll define that X here. V equals to, let's say, contains KY. Okay, so it should return Wiki. Say Wiki. And if I give it to SY, Daisy. If I give it to Z, there is nothing with Z, so it should not return anything. Okay, so guys, so we have covered four things. We have covered starts with, we have covered ends with, we have covered contents, and we have seen all three example with some sort of like parameter. Like when not hard coding anything, here we are just parameterized this thing. And again, you can build this thing dynamically from any CSV file. Like from the CSV, you are building some or getting some sort of data, and you are after that you are passing this data over there. So everything is possible. So this is also very important thing, like for your programming or for developing any sort of logic or application or anything, you definitely need to some sort of search or manipulation where you need to do some sort of like string manipulation or operation over the string. So in that case, like starts with, ends with, and contents is very much like useful. And we have seen how to use it with Python, and as well as if you are not using Python, you can directly use it from Neo4j. So that you also seen it over here, like same thing. Okay, so I think this is enough for this video. So guys, please let me know how you are like finding our videos. Is this going to just giving you any sort of knowledge or not at all helping you? Please give me some sort of feedback or suggestion or advice, or if you have any recommendation for other topics, just to let me know. And if someone is watching our video for the first time, I'll request you to you guys that you should subscribe to our channel and hit the bell icon so that you should not miss the notification, because right now kind of very much active and uploading the videos regularly, and sometimes I'm also uploading videos like two or three times like on a day. So keep practicing, keep learning, keep building your own logic, and do let me know how you are finding our video. So that's all guys, that's all for today. Hope to see you in the next video. Till then, take care, goodbye, and have a nice day.